subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
I'm with Baburam Bhattarai, former Prime Minister of Nepal and a former student of Delhi's Jawaharlal Nehru University. You were in Delhi from 1980 to 1985 and Prime Minister of Nepal from 2011 to 2013 and Ambassador Ranjit Ray, former India's Ambassador to Nepal from 2013 to 2017. Gentlemen, welcome to the Print Debates.
Thank you.
We are connecting the time zones. Prime Minister, former Prime Minister Baburam Bhattarai is in Kathmandu. Ambassador Ranjit Ray is in India. And we are talking today about the situation in Nepal, the situation, first of all, the political situation, what's happening. Prime Minister KP Oli has dissolved the house, the lower house, and has called for snap elections. The Nepal Communist Party has split. Baburamji, your first comments to what is happening inside Nepal.
Yeah, we're passing through very challenging times. We made the constitution through the Constituent Assembly. First ever constitution made by people's representative in Nepal. And we tried to provide a better form of democracy in the 21st century. For that, we went beyond the traditional parliamentary governmental system. And for that, we abolished the prerogative of the Prime Minister to dissolve the parliament whenever he wants. So we made certain provisions so that for 2 years, nobody was allowed to put a no confidence motion against the Prime Minister.
Okay.
And if after 1-2 years no confidence motion was put forward, then the alternate Prime Minister candidate should also be proposed along with the no confidence motion so that there won't be any political vacuum.
Mm-hmm.
And our idea was the House of Representatives could not be dissolved.
Okay.
That was the provision we made in Article 76 of the Constitution.
Mm-hmm.
And this Prime Minister, all of a sudden, has announced the dissolve of Parliament, which is totally unconstitutional, anti-democratic, and in our understanding, it will destroy the fundamentals of the Constitution and lead to political instability in the country. So this is a very dangerous situation. Very strong opposition to it from civil society, lawyers, and the political parties. So we are passing through very hard times.
Ambassador Ray, you've been ambassador in Nepal through a very interesting period. You're also writing a book. You've just written a book on Nepal. What do you make of the situation inside Nepal? Mr. Baburam Bhattarai has just spoken about how there's a period of instability now in Nepal. What do you make of it?
No, I agree with former Prime Minister Dr. Baburam Bhattarai. You know, Nepal in the past had been plagued by considerable instability. You know, 20 governments in as many years. Every few months there would be a new government. So I think when this constitution was drafted, one of the principal objectives of the drafters was to provide for stability. And so the constitution has made it virtually impossible for the house to be dissolved in any legal manner. It's only under certain very, very, complicated circumstances that the house can be dissolved. But here we see that the sitting prime minister, who obviously had lost confidence of the house, dissolves the lower house with the support and consent of the president, and, you know, leading to a big constitutional crisis. And this is coming at a time when Nepal was reeling under the COVID pandemic and its economic after effects. There was a huge problem about labor and migration. Series of agitations were taking place in Nepal,
right,
by, you know, the monarchists, the people who wanted the Hindu Rashtra to be restored, and others.
Mm-hmm.
So a new dimension has now been added to these developments. So certainly very trying times for Nepal.
Dr. Bhattarai, these trying times that you're talking about, but after all, you were very much part of the whole initiative to bring the Nepali Communist Party together, wherein it was united a couple of years ago. Of course, it has split now. So you know what Prime Minister KP Oli was about. So why are you being so critical now?
No, we are not critical about KP Oli. See, we are worried he will destroy the constitution made by the Constituent Assembly for the first time in the history of Nepal. All of the Maoist movement and the Madheshi people's movement all were directed to make a new constitution which would be federal, secular, inclusive. And these fundamental provisions of the constitutions could be dismantled one by one. You see, once the House of
Representatives... Why is he doing it? But my question is that you know the Prime Minister. You were part of... Okay, you're different factions of the Nepal Communist Party, but you did come together. So you know him. So why are you complaining now?
No, it's not a question. I'm not complaining. I'm not in the Nepal Communist Party. So we are in the Janata Samajwadi Party.
I know that, yes.
The People's Socialist Party is a different formation. It's the third largest party in parliament now. Mm-hmm. In our position, our formal position of our party, including the Madheshis and Janjatis, is this constitution is incomplete. The federal restructuring of the state is not satisfactory for the Madheshis and the Janjatis. So we are trying to amend this constitution to cater to the demands of these people. But KP Oli was dead against it. And he, in fact, was not very much reconciled with the progressive democratic content of the constitution. He was a very regressive-minded, very autocratic-minded person. So during the Constituent Assembly, also in the first Constituent Assembly, he lost the election, he was not there. And he was dead against the Madheshi movement and all these Janjati movements and especially the federal restructuring. So we thought this man, under some pretext, will try to weaken and ultimately destroy the constitution. And our apprehension has come true. So we are worried about that.
Ambassador Ray, can you talk a little bit about the visit of Nepal's Foreign Minister Pradeep Gyawali? He is in Delhi very soon to participate in the India-Nepal Joint Commission meetings. We've had a very long last year, 2020, when there was lots of arguments between India and Nepal, including over the row when Nepal published a map which incorporated Indian territory, which was illegal as far as India was concerned. Can you talk a little bit about that and about Pradeep Gyawali's visit?
You know, India is in a bit of a dilemma. And, you know, there was a big row between the two countries when Nepal went and published this new map, as you said. And that led to a long gap in the relationship and the engagement between the two countries. And, you know, there was a sort of vacuum and that was filled in by other forces. So I think the government of India felt that...
What are these other forces, Ambassador?
Well, you know, you can see that in the last few months and years, the role of Nepal's northern neighbor has become, very, very visible.
Are you talking about China?
That's right. And very public. So I think all these factors led the government of India to conclude that, it's not a good idea to have a long gap in the engagement, at least our normal interaction and economic and other kinds of cooperation should continue. And hence, there was this flurry of visits. Mm-hmm. But now, Prime Minister Oli has dissolved the house and there's a big crisis in Nepal. So, you know, this is the dilemma that if you don't engage, there are problems. So I think on balance, the view is that we must continue our engagement. At least our normal cooperation should continue. And I think you have to see the visit of Foreign Minister Pradeep Gyawali in this context. The Joint Commission actually reviews the entire gamut of bilateral cooperation. So I'm happy that at least, this kind of bilateral cooperation, the various projects that we are doing, so discussions can continue on these and hopefully progress can be made on some issues like the Pancheshwar multipurpose hydro project.
Dr. Bhattarai, Ranjit just talked about the role of Nepal's northern neighbor China in the constitutional crisis that is taking place right now. What do you think?
Definitely, Nepal is a very delicate situation, a sandwich between two huge neighbors, India and China. So historically, we have been trying to have a balanced relation with both the neighbors. Definitely, we wouldn't like to have any interference from outside, whether it is north or west or south or anybody. So that is the general principle. But we are more worried about our internal situation, the way our foreign minister is supposed to be visiting Delhi. Definitely, we would have liked to welcome it because we wanted to improve relations with our southern neighbor. We have many of the disputes like boundary disputes and other economic issues. But this is not the appropriate time. So this government is unconstitutional. By our constitution, anybody who is not a member of parliament cannot be the prime minister. The prime minister himself had dissolved the parliament and automatically he has reduced himself to a caretaker government. And how can a caretaker government talk with full authority and enter into any sort of dealing with the foreign country? So I think this is not the right time to visit any country.
But what do you make of the fact that they, after the house was dissolved and the Nepal Communist Party split, there were visits from China in an attempt to bring the factions of the Nepal Communist Party together? What do you make of that?
No, that delegation was from the Communist Party of China. They also visited me and tried to explain their position. What they were saying was, we are not here to interfere, and we just come here to assess the situation. The way news have come out, we are very concerned. You don't have any intention of interfering with any of our neighbors. We just come to assess the situation. That's what they told me. This is what I know. The other, I think it won't be good for me to comment what I don't know.
Okay. Mr. Ray, what do you think? Do you think that the Chinese are, that the role China is playing in Nepal is of course, it's expanding its influence. What do you think of it?
You see, certainly, and I think there's a qualitative change in the kind of diplomacy that China is practicing in Nepal. You know, in the past, their focus really used to be on dealing with the government of the day, ensuring that their interests, on various issues, including in particular the Tibetan issue, were protected, and they were focused on a lot of these projects. But today, I think the party-to-party relationship, between the Nepal Communist Party and the Chinese Communist Party has acquired a life of its own. And as you know, just prior to the visit of President Xi Jinping in 2019, there was also a big visit from the Chinese Communist Party of Nepal. And they are engaged very deeply in terms of training the Nepalese Communist Party on issues like Xi Jinping thought. So my sense is that, the Chinese are looking at the possibility of molding the Nepal Communist Party in the image of the Chinese Communist Party. And, hence they've been trying to get all the communist forces together, to consolidate this presence. So clearly, it's a very, very intrusive engagement. And it's, what's surprising also, it's very public. I mean, you have also, the Nepalese ambassador very, very actively and openly engaged in shuttle diplomacy, trying to sort out problems and patch up differences between leaders of the Nepal Communist Party. So certainly, China is, I think, playing a very big role. And, while recent events may be a setback for them, I think the Chinese presence and role will only increase in the future.
Dr. Bhattarai, do you agree with Ambassador Ray?
No, I don't like to comment on these things. You see, this is since we are in a very delicate situation. You see, we have in fact forced to do a very tightrope walk between our big neighbors. So what I would like to say is we wouldn't like to have any interference in our internal affairs from any side. So this is our formal position. But unfortunately, I wouldn't like to blame the neighbors or international forces. Problem is with us. Internally, we are not able to unite ourselves or there is a dispute or the disenchantment among the various section of the people, including the Madhesis and Janjatis, who themselves aren't very satisfied with the constitution and the government's formation in the country, and there are economic problems, the COVID-19 crisis and unemployment, and all sorts of problems are there. So we are not been able to solve our problems. So until unless there is a national unity on basic issues within the country, then we cannot handle the external situation. So I'm more worried about our own internal problem than the interest of our neighbors and the international forces within the country.
That's a fair point. So Dr. Bhattarai, tell me, do you think that Prime Minister Oli should step down immediately?
No, definitely, he should have done. What he has done is totally unconstitutional. He totally, because I was the chairman of the Constitutional Committee. I know every letter, whatever the discuss, how every article was passed through. So there is no provision to dissolve House of Representatives in the present constitution. He had totally done an unconstitutional move, and this will destabilize the country, and this won't be good for anybody within the country and to our neighbors and to the international community. So we were very concerned about it.
What do you think, Ambassador Ray? Do you think that this constitution, which came after so many years of trial and error, if you like, I mean, I covered the Jan Andolan in 2006, when the transition from monarchy to a democratic country took place, and so I'm wondering what is going to happen now when you have Prime Minister Oli, which has dissolved the House and created this kind of a crisis?
Well, you know, a lot would depend on how the Supreme Court decides on this matter. You know, it's sub judice and they have to give a judgment in terms of whether dissolution of the House was constitutional or not. So I think a lot would depend on it. But, you know, the Constitution is really the outcome of very serious negotiations on the great issues of Nepal, of republicanism, of secularism, of a federal polity. And, you know, these issues had emerged out of the Maoist insurgency, out of the Madhesi Andolans. So it is, you know, there's a lot of blood, sweat, tears, violence that have gone into the forging of this constitution. And obviously, any action that weakens the constitution, especially in terms of its implementation, then again reopens these issues, because there are a lot of forces that are unhappy with what has been achieved in the constitution. So it's in their interest that, you know, if these issues get reopened, they can pursue their own partisan motives. So my sense is that, you know, this could again push Nepal into a period of instability and turmoil. And that is very unfortunate, because, you know, we've seen turmoil in Nepal for many, many decades.
Dr. Bhattarai, do you think that Prime Minister Oli is becoming this very sort of authoritarian character? He doesn't listen to anybody, does what he wants. I remember during the 2017 elections when he was so dismissive of the Madhesis. Before that, as you know, there was a big blockade in 2015. And today PM Oli is holding a dhoti rally. There were some reports of a dhoti rally being held. What are your comments?
That is ridiculous. People are taking the insult on the Madhesi people, bringing out a dhoti rally in Kathmandu and not heeding to the genuine demands of the Madhesis, humiliating Madhesis, branding them as anti-national, and now for his partisan politics, he's indulging such gimmicks. Apart from that, Mr. Oli, I'm very sorry to comment on my Prime Minister. He's of a very autocratic character. After becoming the Prime Minister, he has centralized everything, and his interference in the independent judiciary and the constitutional body is well known, and the rampant corruption and the cronyism developed around him. All these things has really hampered the peace, stability and development of the country. So instead of resigning from parliament, Prime Minister and given an opportunity for the parliament to elect a new prime minister, he has dissolved the parliament. So this is very unfortunate. You see, according to our constitution, many people, our friends in India may not know, that as long as there is a chance, there is a possibility of forming a government from within the parliament, you cannot dissolve the parliament. You have to go through series of stages. Only when there is no possibility of making a new government, only then you can dissolve the parliament.
Right.
This is against the known parliamentary practice, where the majority government or the prime minister commanding majority may dissolve and go for a new election. That is the general practice, of which are also conditioned by law and constitution in other countries also. But in Nepal, as long as there is a possibility of forming a new government, you can't dissolve the parliament. This is what is written in our constitution, and I was the chairman of the constitution committee.
But I have seen reports that former prime minister, now leader of the Nepali Congress, Shiv Bahadur Deuba, he is now talking to Prime Minister Oli, and perhaps there could be some sort of power sharing between the two.
How will they share power? You see, now there is a vacuum, political vacuum. When there is no parliament, you can't be a prime minister. You have categorically written in the constitution, the prime minister will automatically, he will be taken as losing his position once he is not a member of parliament. Mm-hmm. So when there is no parliament, so how can you share the power? You can't form the new government. For that, you will have to have parliament.
Right.
So there is a big crisis, you see, big constitutional crisis.
Ambassador Ray, what are your comments about Mr. Oli? There has been a lot of bad blood between India and Nepal. Do you think it's his personality that exacerbates it? What do you make of it?
You know, I really think this is the politics of self-interest and tactical advantage. And my own sense is that, once he realized that he did not have the support of, people say that initially the Chinese were supporting him very strongly, and thereafter they started supporting the unity of the party rather than the leadership. And that, once Prime Minister Oli got a sense of this, that's when he really turned to India. And then there was this flurry of visits. So my sense is, these are tactical approaches, and unfortunately are going to lead to very complicated after effects, long-term after effects in Nepal. I think it's really very unfortunate that this has happened.
On this note, gentlemen, thank you so much for participating in the print debates. Ambassador Ranjit Ray, former Prime Minister of Nepal, Dr. Baburam Bhattarai, thank you so much for your time, for joining me from Kathmandu, and I will call upon you personally to invite you to participate in other debates, but thank you so much for your time today. And to you, Ambassador.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.